pretty common. That's probably it.
Quarter inch.
I don't know. It's working.
So this is the fuel cell that I wound up actually ordering. This is a 20-gallon RCI fuel cell. If you look under the car, again, you'll notice that it comes out with a 90, and then there's a little bit of AN line, and then it goes to 100 micron filter here. This will kind of sift out some of the big stuff that might get in the tank.
Five-hour energy, real bad. Something, coffee. All right, guys. Well, this is the fifth take or more of this quick little update video, but it's been 2 months since the last one. It's been long enough. I really need to make one, and why not at 7 o'clock in the morning while the neighbor's rooster is making a bunch of noise? I am deliriously tired, and am probably gonna slur all my words through this like I'm drunk, but. I figured it was time for an update. So, for those of you that are maybe new to the channel or new to these project videos of this particular car, this is a 68 GTO. It was originally a Lucian blue, but as you can see, I've gone with a different color scheme for it slightly. Some of you are going to hate that, but you know, you can build your own. The engine is a 400 Pontiac. It has a mild cam in it, nothing crazy. It's got a little bit of lope to it. Really good mid-range cam. It's got a roller tip rockers, new push rods. It's got ARP head bolts, cosmetic gaskets, Edelbrock aluminum intake, 750 quick fuel slayer, so on, long tube headers, stuff like that. The transmission is a pretty beefed up turbo 400. It has red frictions, custom valve body, and a 2500 stall. I don't remember what the brand on the stall is. It's been a while. But it's good to, who knows. I asked if it was good to 800 and the guy kind of chuckled, so enough. But it'll be fine for this. This thing's probably only making like 350 currently. Anyway, and the rear end is it's the factory 68 10 volt. I don't know the gear set that's in it. It was supposed to be 293s. I don't believe that it is. It was also supposed to be an open diff. It's not. I have no clue what's in there, but it seems fine.
We could open the hood and show you the motor. It's real dirty, but like from a distance, maybe. No. Wait till the next one. Yeah. Is that dirty?
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
It's a really pretty blue normally. Right now, it's gray.
It needs good cleaning.
Yeah. We'll post a picture, though.
The windshield is painted, you might notice, and that's because he's got a brand new one in the box. So.
Yeah, I actually got that here yesterday. I was going to originally put a 69 bumper on this. I decided not to do that because it's a gigantic pain in the ass, and I went ahead and ordered a 68 bumper that's over there. Not sure what color that's going to get to be. Probably one of the assortment that's on it because the chrome's bad. But I got 68 bumper brackets. I got 68 brand new taillight lenses. The whatever you call them.
Sockets.
Socket.
Mm-hmm.
I got all of that. So it's going to have really shiny taillights for some reason. But I do have all of that, so it's going to be a complete 68. It's not going to be some hybrid car. I don't know if I mentioned, this is actually a real 68 GTO, too. It's not a Le Mans clone to a GTO or anything like that, which I have nothing against. I think Le Mans is really cool. I forgot to mention the suspension. The car does have full QA1 suspension on the front end. It's got a tubular upper and lower control arms. It's got the factory sway bar. It's got a right stuff disc brake conversion kit. They're drilled and slotted rotors, single piston disc brakes. I actually have a dual piston set up in a box. I don't want to put it on because that's run bigger wheels. Trying to think. In the inside of the car, since last time, I don't believe I showed the roll cage, but I put a roll cage in it. It has a 10-point Jegster, whatever you want to call it, roll bar. Roll cage in this one, but it's pretty beefy. I did a decent job putting it in. it's welded directly to the frame. I had to cut holes in the floor that I had just patched, which was kind of a bummer. But by the way, the inside of the car right now, just as trashed as the engine bay. I tried to blow it out with an air hose for the purpose of this video, but it did absolutely nothing.
Yeah, there's all kind of body dust in there, but does have a Hurst Outlaw shifter on the 400.
Yeah, it does.
Pretty cool.
And it's got switches and a push-button start and stuff like that. The seats, I just went with some generic Jegs, high back twos, something or others. And it does have RJS cam lock harnesses. They're 5-point. And they're actually certified till 2021.
And, of course, he has the covers for the seats and everything.
Yeah, I didn't put those on because of,
obviously,
you know, obvious reasons. The seats are actually mounted to brackets that are obviously bolted to the floor, but the harness bar, the seats also come with these this like kind of plate that comes off the back, and I welded tabs to the harness bar, so the seats are fixed to the harness bar and the floor, so they're in there very sturdily. Moving to the back of the car, not a whole lot to show, but it's got a set of Nitto drag radials on the back. They're 275s. It also has a set of aluminum race star wheels. They're skinnies in the front. They're 4 inches wide instead of the threes, though. Also, up under the car, I did go with a 20-gallon, I think, RCI fuel cell. Can't quite remember. But it has a 100-micron filter off the back of it, and then there's another 40 up front before it goes into the car. But it's pretty cool looking. I have to get it out in the daylight. It's actually probably one of my favorite things about the car. I really love fuel cells. When I put the fuel cell in, I countersunk it into the trunk and I basically boxed it in and welded brackets to the frame rails so that it would be very strong and not fall out. But I wanted to countersink it because I just like being able to see it from behind the car. I think that's kind of neat.
Might as well see if it'll fire up.
It's very cold. It might.
It is real cold out here, guys.
Hey. As an excuse, if it doesn't run, I used that battery yesterday, to operate a gravel dumping trailer or whatever. So.
Yeah, the battery got weak on the dump trailer, so he had to use it.
5 tons of rock, so if there's a problem, blame that.
See what happens.
It has long tube headers, like I mentioned, 3-inch collector, and then it goes to 3-inch extensions, 3-inch H-pipe, and then back out of the H-pipe to 3-inch Flowmaster Super 10s. Some guys like Flowmaster, some don't. I think they sound good on this. I originally had bullet mufflers on it, and I hated it. It sounded too ratty, so I put those on instead. I don't know. I mean, I got a lot done since the last update video, I think. I know it. Some guys are not going to like the styling decisions, I guess, but this is what I'm into. I like ratty muscle cars. I like the General Mayhem car charger. I like all that stuff, so this is pretty much what I intended to do with it since I got it. Actually, to be fair, this is much further than I had intended to go since I got it, because I have actually replaced at least a piece or an entire panel of every single panel on this entire car.
Yeah, really. I mean, core support, cowl, fenders, quarters, floor.
I rebuilt the pillars, the inner body structure. Both fenders are patched front and back. I had to patch the hood. The roof, I actually had to cut holes in the roof to weld in the roll cage, so I had to patch the roof. Really fun time, by the way. Bolt doors, bolt rockers, quarter panels, trunk pan, trunk, the package tray, I completely made that out of stuff I had laying around. Firewall, everything. I mean, everything. But it's here. It's three colors, but it's here. There's no giant gaping holes in it. At least none that I haven't, you know, none that I know about at this
and
point.
He has a new rear window upstairs. He has a new windshield. All the trim around the windshield, all the trim around the back window. So it'll, you know.
Yeah, all the trim was in the trunk when I got it, and I just the other day pieced it together, laid it out on the car, and I have everything somehow.
It's also going to have a brand new painless fuse panel, so it'll all be updated.
That already. The only thing I haven't quite worked out is the turn signal stalk inside of the column is messed up. I might just order the kit to do it. It's fairly expensive, though. I have a cheap little $35 fix for it sitting here right now for the time being, though. Also, I am planning on putting a removable hub, like a quick-release hub, and a new steering wheel on the car. I like the big factory steering wheels, but it's so big that it's putting my knuckles awful close to my roll cage tube, and I don't really like that, so... Anyway, there's a lot of stuff I still have yet to do. The car, like mentioned, needs completely wired. It's wired enough that it runs and does burnouts. Mm-hmm. The fans work and stuff like that, but other than that, it needs all of it. Also, I did get a new 68 bumper sitting over there. I have 68 bumper brackets. I have a 69 bumper and 69 bumper brackets out here too, but I was gonna put those on and I decided against it. It's a little cooler just to leave it 68 in my opinion. I'm not sure what color the bumper is going to be. I'll probably pick from the assortment on the car, and it'll match one of them. Might be black, I don't know. The chrome on it's peeling pretty bad.
Yeah, so. They look good painted on these anyway. It kind of makes it blend into the body more. Mm-hmm. And in a way, I think it makes sense because you don't have chrome up here. You know, yeah, this is all painted, you know.
The Enduro bumper was body color. Yeah. It's kind of weird the back bumper wasn't, but... Anyway, yeah, I have that. I ordered the sockets for the taillights, which are... very affordable. And I ordered the taillight lenses, also very affordable. I will never build another one of these.
The cost of the bumper and taillights alone is ridiculous. It really is.
Yeah, that hurt. That mm-hmm. hurt. I don't want to think about it. Anyway, yeah, like I've mentioned, glass bumper taillights. I have all of it here. I have the full painless wiring kit. I have everything here currently. Seat covers, all of it. I have everything that I would need to finish this car, unless maybe the bulbs do not work on the taillights and headlights. So
maybe we'll do a burnout another day, but right now it's a freezing cold motor. I'm not going to, you know, crank on it or anything.
I also don't have a temp gauge hooked up.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, but, you know.
It'll get plenty of abuse later.
Yeah. And like I had mentioned, the engine that's in this currently is not extremely mean. The bottom end is reasonably beefed up. It has aftermarket rods. It has, I think, either Speed Pro or TRW, I don't quite remember, pistons in it, stuff like that, but nothing crazy. But it'll withstand a little bit of abuse, and it'll make some decent power. These are mostly giant torque monster motors anyway, so.
Mm. Oh, yeah. I mean, it rolls those drag radials off, no problem.
I do plan on building something more substantial for it, though.
Yeah, so. It'll end up with a crazy Butler motor in it at some point.
Yeah. I was picking through cylinder heads the other day at my buddy's house, and I've been looking up the Butler short block kits and all that stuff, so I don't know. I don't have that kind of money laying around right this minute, though, so that's going to be a little bit. I don't know if you guys have gotten on the Butler site, but I don't quite have that kind of cash unless I go selling some stuff. But anyway, I hope you like this quick update. I'm going to go lay down. So, I hope you guys have a good day. Thank you for watching and commenting. And if you're new, hopefully you enjoyed this. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.